Hey guys, welcome back to the Geek Box. So today we're going to be doing another guide for Hitman World of Assassination. Obviously on the winter roadmap we've got a new outfit to unlock. We're going to be heading to Whittington Creek and we're going to be unlocking using the public enemy challenge. So we're going to be taking out both targets using an SMG or an assault rifle. I'm going to be doing a default loadout only on this one because let's face it, outside of that you can pretty much just go in and gun everybody down with either. So just to show you how to do it, we're going to keep it Silent Assassin as well, as obviously we like to always try and do our best, and if you want to wrap up the mission you've got a chance to do Silent Assassin still. So that being said, the only thing left is if you do like the video please hit that like button, and of course if you haven't already hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the latest content. So that being said, let's get into it. So then, starting off, so you can let the cutscene play if you want to, it doesn't make a huge difference. So just starting off, we're going to head to the left and we're going to make our way straight to the Blake tent, and we're just going to grab a hammer. Reason being, this first guard that we're going to take out, I had a few times where it did that thing where you go to choke them and it spins them around and turns it into a fight. So head along the fence, just crouch down, don't hug the wall, don't know what I did there, but crouch down and make your way through the long grass, and then we're going to jump over the fence here and we're going to take on this first guard because conveniently he has the submachine gun we need. So dragging him into the bushes here, we are now got a not only an SMG but we've got a silenced one, and on top of that we've also got a disguise we can use. So one thing to point out as well here is don't worry about the cameras catching you if you want to stay Silent Assassin. When we take out Cassidy we are going to be dealing with the cameras at the same time, which is quite convenient. But heading on through the gate in front, we're going to turn to the left, you've seen, we're going to head along here and we're going to jump over the barrier here and we're going to go grab the pesticide that they're using. So if you haven't already, this is also one of the other things you have to do on the level anyway, so you can get a few extras for this. But grab the crowbar here on the barrel and then make your way to the green container and use that crowbar then to ping the door open. So in here you're going to find the pesticides that you need, so grabbing them we're then going to make our way back out. Just take the same path so you don't get spotted. If you obviously want to make sure you keep on Silent Assassin, just heading around the back way and cutting down. And now we're going to go after the other target, Yanis. We're not going to go to Cassidy first, so just speeding it up a little bit, as obviously there is a lot of walking on this level. You're going to make your way around past the statue, go past the boat, and then you're going to see there's guards in bright coloured outfits, so you know you're at Yanis's house. Heading to the outside here, I was going to jump on this pipe, climb up. You will be spotted, but they never see you long enough for it to be a problem unless you literally just hang there. So make our way in, and now we're going to get ourselves a disguise so we can move around a bit more freely up here. So this guard, sometimes he'll spot you quickly to go. Sometimes you might want to use a coin, as I went to do here, but then he will turn again. So if needs be, you can use the peekaboo method. As you see here, use the peekaboo method just to draw him in. So we're going to spam the button as he gets to the door. So we grab him, choke him, drag him around the corner. Somehow that still counts as not seeing you, even though you literally look at each other face to face before you do it. But just drag him off a little bit and then you're going to take his disguise in a moment. So we're going to take out the other guard here. You can use the same method. I've noticed sometimes it's a bit 50-50 if he actually reacts to coins and stuff. As you can see here, I dropped a coin down and obviously there's the gun there as well, so you can use that to lure him in. The guy will always drop the gun around there from choking him on the corner anyway, so it works out quite well. If not, you can place another coin there if you want to lure him in, but usually the gun takes dominance. So just making sure you flip the door open. As he gets there, same again, spam the button and we're going to choke him out and take him down. So with our choice now, we're going to take one of their outfits and that's going to let us freely move along the floor. See, at the moment you'd probably find Yanis is downstairs. He will come up shortly coughing and spluttering, but she fast forwarding to when he's upstairs. He and the only other guard that's now left that's going around with him, his personal guard, will go into the other room. So you can avoid the camera here, doesn't make a difference anyway. I find it easier if you go through this door just because he will fully turn his back to this part, so you can pang a hammer at the back of his head. You'll get spotted, but you're going to kill the target anyway, so it's not going to make any difference. So hitting him, switch to your rifle and shots in the face. So Nobody comes up here really, so you can leave it if you want. But if you do want peace of mind, like I did here, you can drag them both into this closet that's here. So don't worry about the camera clipping through the wall there. It doesn't actually see you with what you're doing here, so you're not going to get spotted committing a crime or anything. But with both their bodies there, if you want to pick up everything, because it's a bit of a cleanup recce, you may notice when I do these things, I like to clean up everything I can on the go. But heading back down now, we are now going to make our way over to Cassidy's house. So head back over, pick up your disguise, and jump out the window like you did before. Again, once you do this, there's going to be a good bit of running across, as this is quite a big sandbox map, I find, compared to some of the other levels. But fast forwarding, so you ain't just got to watch me burrowing around. We're going to reverse where we went before and head back to the original house. So at this point, Cassidy should have done most of his route round. It might take a little longer depending on how quickly you've done the first part of this, etc. But we're going to sneak up, we're going to then put the pesticide in the machine. So we're going to drop that in, and then we're going to have to wait for Cassidy. So I'm going to skip this bit forwards, but it'll have a conversation about the equipment outside of his house. And then once he said about, like, make sure they fix it and stuff, he will then return to the property that he's in. So obviously you can already have walked out and just blasted him in the face if you want to complete the challenge. I'm just showing you the Silent Assassin way of going about it. So the moment you've taken out the first target, you can do that. You can do this at the beginning if you actually bring along as well some sedative. You don't have to find a pesticide. You can run and do this at the start really quickly to do exactly what I'm doing here, but it's a bit messier. But with this version, we're going to wait until he gets into the house here. So you want him to be nearly to where you are level. It just, if you do it earlier, it's one of them gets spotted as they fall and it can actually lose your rating. So activate the machine, turn it back off afterwards, because obviously it brings a guy in to investigate. But that's now knocked out everybody in the house, so you can just make your way into the house. Obviously, again, going in, just find out where he's dropped. Obviously here he's dropped to the back room, in a most awkward place for me. But as you're going through, destroy the security footage whichever way you prefer to do it, and then take out your rifle, SMG, whatever you're using, and put a bullet in his head. Obviously I've stuck with the covert, you get to start. But you see, public enemy's done, so that now has unlocked you the public enemy outfit, which I have to say, I actually really like this outfit. I am doing a bit extra here to show, if you do want to complete this, drag him into the garage, hit the button to close it up, and you can hide his body here in the chest, freezer, fridge, etc. So you then can carry on without being identified, any bodies being found, etc. Depends how you want to go about it. As always with these challenges, once it's done, it's done. You don't need to finish the level now to unlock it. You can do, like I say, if you want, so I showed the Silent Assassin way. But if we look at it, the public enemy suit, Absolve in this stylish black suit with black driving gloves and an elegant black campaign hat to match, sure to pack a punch with anyone who refuses. So with that being a new suit and we're here on the Geekbox, that means a montage.